Good morning, students. Today we will study about lesson 2, Geography, Physical Features of India. We all know that we have studied in lesson 1 that India is entirely located in northern hemisphere and it has 28 states and 8 union territories. Now we know that India is such a rich country that it has all types of physical features. All type of physiographic divisions of India are the Himalayan mountains, northern plains, peninsular plateau, Indian desert, coastal plains and island groups. Now the question arises that how these physical features are made. Now you all know that beneath the earth there are many tectonic plates. 7 major and some minor tectonic plates are there, and there is a movement in these plates because they are floating on the molten magma. So when there is a movement in these plates, sometimes they collide with each other and any other physical feature is formed. So in this way, mountains, plains, desert, plateau and islands are formed. Earth scientists have given theory of plate tectonics. According to this theory, the crust of Earth has been formed out of 7 major and some minor plates. This is answer of question, what do you mean by plate tectonics? So theory of plate tectonic means the crust of Earth has been formed out of 7 major and some minor plates. And I have told that there is movement in these plates. So 3 types of movement is found in these plates, that is convergent boundary, divergent boundary and transform boundary. Now convergent boundary, when 2 plates come towards each other, it is called convergent boundary. Divergent boundary means when 2 plates go away from each other, it is called divergent boundary. And in transform boundary, plates go up and down towards each other. And now the question arises that in the north we have Great Himalayas, northern Himalayan mountains. And now it is a question that how these Himalayan mountains were formed. These are young fold mountains and very important for our country. They are boundary in the north and east of India, natural boundary. And they save us from very cold winds which are coming from Siberia. And they are source of all rivers. So are very, very important. Now the question arises how these Himalayas were formed. The oldest landmass, Gondwana land, it included India, South America, Australia, South Africa, Antarctica. It was a single landmass in which these days countries or continent, they were in the single landmass. It was Gondwana land, and beneath the earth there was convectional current. Due to this convectional current, earth's crust split into number of pieces, and that there was an uplift movement in the Indo-Australian plate towards north, and there it collided with the much larger Eurasian plates. So in this way, Australian plate moved towards north and collided with Eurasian plate, and because of this collision, what happened? Sedimentary rocks which were accumulated in the geosaline Tethys or in the Tethys Sea, they were folded to form a mountain system. It is called Himalayas. So in this way, Himalayan mountains were formed. So up to this, their question comes, exercise question, how Himalayas were formed. This back exercise question, you can note down answer from here. And here one more question is, describe three types of plate movement, that is convergent boundary, divergent boundary and transform boundary. And one more question is, describe theory of plate tectonics. Thank you and have a nice day.